This is nearly 3 weeks after a new DPS has been appointed. At best, that demonstrates the DPS has not gained effective control over the premises because the staff didn't know who they should be speaking to. But at worst, it does show that he still has involvement with the premises some 3 weeks after being told he doesn't. The licence holder today has not convinced me that her involvement or knowledge of the business only started when she signed the lease agreement. I'm further not convinced that, despite the lease agreement, that this is a completely new regime that has come in and bought a business. There remain links, or there appear to remain links, to those who were involved with the running of that business at the time of the offences. Based upon the reported offences at the premises and having regard to the statutory guidance, in order to address the issues being caused by those premises, I still believe the only option available to ensure the objectives are not further undermined is for consideration be given to the premises licence being revoked. I would urge that the subcommittee to consider taking this important and as I said earlier, robust step. And I did say earlier, but it is part of summing up that it doesn't just affect this premises, it will also act as a deterrent to other premises who may engage in similar practices. The Licensing Act hangs around four licensing objectives, and they are paramount to how any premises runs their business at any one time. And the fact that this prevention of crime and disorder has been undermined is a serious matter, and the guidance does state